I love spray paint because it's so easy to use, but there are 10 golden rules you need to follow to get a good result. So I'm gonna take you through those top 10 rules while I work on a simple project. Let's get started. First rule is definitely masking. I'm gonna paint this computer case, but I don't wanna get paint on the outside or on some of the components. So I'm gonna be very careful and mask off everything. I do not want to get paint on it. Spray paint is infamous for getting into places that you didn't think that it was going to get into. So literally, if you don't want paint on it, make sure that it's masked. Take your time.
Good
example of masking something you probably wouldn't have thought of, especially things like screw holes. So these screw holes hold on the motherboard of the computer, and I do not want to get paint inside of them because these really fine screws will have a hard time. So there is a super simple solution. I could put something in there, or I could just simply put the screws in there and then just paint the tops of the screws. I'm not worried about the tops of the screws. So this will keep paint out. The first two rules actually go hand in hand, and the next one is to prep the surface. Make sure that your surface is ready for paint. But the reason those first two go together is because you can prep the surface first and then mask, or you can mask and then prep the surface, whichever is easiest, but they're pretty interchangeable. So whatever works for your project, just go in there.
Cloth works great to get dust out of, especially projects like this.
Just make sure that your project is completely dry before you go to the next step.
Surface is going to be difficult to paint, and it's usually pretty easy to tell if it's glossy, if it's super smooth, then you can always scuff it up. But just remember, if you use like a Scotch-Brite pad to scuff up a surface, just make sure you go back and wipe it down again and get all that dust off. But you can certainly use a Scotch-Brite pad, or you can use a wire brush if you think your paint's gonna have trouble. My surface is pretty rough, and it's now that it's wiped down and clean, I think I'm good.
I'm gonna use just a tiny bit of primer. I'm not gonna go hog wild. And the idea is to simply make sure that there's a nice clean layer for the paint to stick on when it actually hits my project. If this was plastic, I'd probably, instead of using primer, I would probably use adhesion promoter, which would probably be a little bit better. But remember, for this step, super, super light.
Next good rule of thumb is to make sure that your paint is warm. If you live somewhere warm, this is not a huge issue. But if you live somewhere where it's cold, especially in the winter, you need to make sure that your paint is warm because it helps it flow a lot easier. First of all, it brings the consistency of the paint down a little bit so it's thinner, and it actually pressurizes the can a little bit more because the gas inside expands when it gets warm. Then, so you get a better atomization, which means you don't get that splotchy spray, you get that super nice, strong, fine mist, and that's what you're looking for. The easiest way to do it is just get some random bucket, fill it up with hot water, and leave your paint can in there for about 10 minutes or so, and your paint should be good. Now, once you have warmed it up, make sure to shake it up. That way it'll get nice and mixed and be ready to go.
Next, a really good rule of thumb is to stay within one brand. I started with some Rust-Oleum primer. I'm gonna use some Rust-Oleum metallic gold, and then I'm gonna use some Rust-Oleum clear. Also, if you're using enamel, then make sure you use enamel clear coat. If you're using acrylic, try to use an acrylic clear coat. This will save you a lot of problems down the line because of the compatibility issues sometimes you get by trying to use two different brands. You get some weird stuff going on with spray paint. So the easiest rule of thumb is when you go out and buy paint for your project, try to stay within the same brand all the way across from prep to color to clear coat.
The thing I want to talk about is using very light coats and smooth strokes. What you don't want to do on any project is just hit it with spray paint. You'll get a very splotchy effect. What you want to do is, say your project is right here, you want to start the paint, go across your project, stop the paint. And you want to do it very, very smoothly, and you want to do a very light coat. You don't want to gob it on. So for example, I'm going to start my paint, go over my project, stop my paint. And you get a pretty even line. So nice, even strokes in my projects right here. Now, it's gonna be a little bit more complicated if I go inside my case, But the same concept applies, because if you start your paint in your project, go across your project, and then undo your paint, watch what happens. First of all, you get this barbell effect. And what it is you get a bunch of paint up front, a bunch of paint on the end, and then too much paint in the middle usually, because you're not moving nice and smooth. And you can see this is on a flat surface and it already even wants to drip. So the key here is light coats, smooth strokes.
Now for a project that's a little bit complex, there's a lot of curves and I'm gonna be working inside here, the real key here is very, very light coats. If in any spot in here, if I try to put too much paint down at one time, it's definitely gonna run. So just take your time. I'm gonna do this in probably 5 or 6 coats, but they're all gonna be super light, and I'm just gonna concentrate on hitting different angles to make sure everything gets paint that I want to get. This is what a normal first coat should look like. Notice that it's very, very light and I barely got some spots, but I'd rather do this 6 times than try to do it in one time and have a bunch of drips. So remember, light coats, smooth strokes.
The next rule of thumb is that between coats, once you make sure that coat is nice and dry, you've given it a solid 10-15 minutes, as long as it's dry, depends of course on the temperature, but as long as it's nice and dry, it's okay to take your lint-free cloth and go over your project before the next coat of paint. That way, you can make sure there's no dust on the paint before you put another layer of paint on. Once a piece of dust is trapped in there and then you put another layer of paint on it, you're never getting it back. It's gonna get worse and worse after each next subsequent coat of paint. So this is a great opportunity to dust your paint off before the next coat.
The drying box is a really cool technique that I figured out over the years, and I didn't come up with it. The concept is super simple. Just take a big cardboard box, put it over your project, take a hairdryer and plug it into the underneath the cardboard box, put it on super low heat and super low air circulation, and it will create a good environment for your project to dry correctly if you're having trouble drying between coats or once we get to the clear coat as well.
The next rule is that stencils are king when it comes to spray paint, but the difference between the pros and the Joes when it comes to stencils is you need to measure. Never eyeball anything involving a stencil, because it's a lot easier to measure these things out 2 or 3 times and paint once than have to paint over, screw it up, paint over, and do it again. So good rule of thumb, measure twice, paint once.
Last but not least, whenever you're using stencils, is to make sure the stencil sits as flat as possible on your project, because any space between the stencil and your project is going to get fuzzy. It's going to give you fuzzy lines. The better and sharper lines are, the better that your stencil is super, super close and there's no space.
Another rule of thumb, the better that you can get a good angle, basically straight up and down or straight against, you want the paint to come and hit the stencil straight on. That also helps give you nice crisp lines as opposed to fuzzy lines.
Rule we have to talk about is this thing called recoat times. Every single different paint has directions on the back that we all gaff off all the time, but one of them is really important, and that's the times in which you can put on one coat and then another. So what's interesting is on this Rust-Oleum it actually says in the directions you can put a coat on as many coats as you want within 1 hour, but after that, after 1 hour, you need to wait about 48 hours. It has to do with the chemical compounds inside the paint, and what'll happen is you'll start to get some weird effects, like the paint will wrinkle and things like that. It gets super dicey when you start dealing with clear coat. Clear coat is usually where you start to see these problems. And a good rule of thumb is when you're doing clear coat, try to get your clear coat at least a light dusting on with spray paint on very soon after you put your
first or your last layer of spray paint on. Spray paint clear coats are the worst. They have the most problems, and that's why it's so cool to go to different, more advanced clear coats like automotive. They don't have these problems, at least not as bad as is spray paint clear coat. But the big thing here is to read the directions on the specific paint that you're using and the specific clear coat that you're using. And it's not just the clear coat, it's every single coat. So make sure to mind your coating times, and hopefully you can keep your project from getting squirrels. All right, so we're ready for clear coat. Now, same principles and all the rules apply to clear coat as other types of paint. So make sure that your paint is nice and warm, ready to go, and it's nice and mixed up, and that you're painting in a good temperature, and make sure that your paint is dusted off and the surface is ready to go. And then, of course, make sure you do light coats, smooth strokes, because it shows up tremendously inside the clear coat when you put too much down at once. So super light coat at first, and then a little bit heavier coats as you clear coat, even on parts that might not need a bunch of durability, because even though they might not need to be glossy or anything like that, even putting clear coat on regular paint adds to its durability and makes it a lot more durable, and makes sure that it'll last a lot longer. So first coat, super, super light. That's pretty much it when it comes to the top 10 rules to just keep yourself out of trouble when you're working with spray paint. Spray paint can be awesome because it's so easy to use, but it can cause you some seriously crazy problems. It'll drive you insane. If you follow these 10 simple steps, your next project will be great and fairly painless. So if you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.